The Stearns County Sheriff's Office is trying something new when it comes to cracking cold cases. It's called Investigative Genetic Genealogy.
Our Eric Shalhoub spoke with investigators and researchers trying to solve these old central Minnesota crimes.
Labor Day 1974, 12-year-old Susan and 15-year-old Mary Rieker went to eat at the St. Cloud department store's lunch counter and never made it back home. Their bodies were later found in a granite quarry outside of town. The sisters had been fatally stabbed. Their killer has never been found.
I made the decision that now is the time. Now is the time to try things that we've maybe haven't tried before.
Lieutenant Zach Sorensen sent the Rieker's case and other Stearns County cold cases off for new testing.
We owe it to our community, to these victims' families and loved ones.
As citizen sleuths, we get pretty close to these cases without, you know, ever carrying a badge and a gun.
The center works with a lab that provides them with the advanced DNA data obtained from evidence in a case. The data identifies hundreds of thousands of genetic markers, more detailed than traditional DNA testing results. The team then runs the profile through 3 million DNA records stored on the site's GEDmatch and Family Tree DNA.
It's really a lot of genealogy. It's a lot of sorting through public records, trying to build up family trees and identify common ancestors between relatives of the individual we're trying to identify.
This is a huge victory for our agency.
Last fall, the IGG team helped the Dunn County, Wisconsin Sheriff's Office make an arrest in a 50-year-old murder case. The DNA from a hair found in a stocking cap left at the scene helped genetic researchers build a family tree that eventually led deputies to identify a suspect who is now facing criminal charges.
There's a lot of risk involved when you start consuming evidence.
It's a risk the lieutenant says investigators must take to find justice for the victims' families.
We have hope. And with hope comes light that we can provide some of those answers to the individuals who have been impacted by this for decades.
Eric Shalhoub, 5 Eyewitness News.